It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back to it, your Feel Good Breakfast Show, live, large and in charge. Happy Wednesday to you. So good to be in your company. Time for us right now to take you through some of the most exciting stories we found in the world of technology. One involving Elon Musk's SpaceX, which made not just one, but two new milestones earlier on this week as part of its bid to create a global broadband network through its Starlink satellite internet service.
Free Wi-Fi for all.
Yeah, exactly. That's the world we're going for.
Yeah, right, man.
Bring it. So check it out. The commercial spaceflight company has confirmed that it had successfully launched 60 satellites into space and will begin distributing them in orbit far above the Earth. And the hope is that the company will leverage its network of satellites to beam high-speed internet to various regions on Earth where customers will be able to then connect to the web. Now, the firm made the event a startling success, which is even more impressive considering that SpaceX deployed those 60 satellites from a reusable rocket that, as of now, has now made four successive trips wow. into orbit that have then each resulted in successful landings. That is,
how far have
what
we
on
come,
earth?
Man?
Yeah, man. And when you consider space debris and space waste and all of that, this is revolutionary what they've done.
It really is. I do think about it, not that I have like sleepless nights about it, but I do think think a lot about the amount of space debris and the amount of kind of satellites and things we've got, you know, orbiting the Earth at the moment. The design of these things, because once they're up, they've got to kind of just do their thing. They've got to run autonomously and look after themselves. And, you know, so it's a designed feat. But I can't help but think about kind of on the show when we were doing these tech updates three, 4 years ago, all of this was just hypothesis. We were just talking about the possibility of doing these things, of getting person to Mars, of colonies on Mars, of free Wi-Fi for all. And now it literally is. It feels like we've sped up exponentially.
Yeah, we have. And,
the
impact that can have on so many services, necessary services, like for instance, healthcare in remote regions,
in rural
having
areas.
Access to communication,
information.
That is just massive. So
empowering, man.
Go, Elon.
So let's go from up there to down there to the deepest, darkest depths. We know that when it comes to pollution in the oceans, it's not just about the smaller or the microplastics that are floating on the surface or close to the surface when it comes to cleaning up the ocean, but a lot of the heavier materials will fall to the bottom of the ocean. And there are particular little creatures that are experts at reversing those coral reefs and those rocky depths of the ocean. I'm talking about sea urchins, okay? So they have a completely unique design when it comes to nature.
Spiky and very painful to step on.
Yeah, spiny, and they're kind of like, they seem angry in their design. Some researchers at Harvard University have copied these complex creatures. They've got two movable appendages, so almost like 2 feet underneath them, moving spines and sticky tube-like feet for gripping. So they're almost ideally designed for moving through crevices and really hard to reach places.
Good, cool, cool.
So they've designed a robot built on this design dynamic that can then move across the bottom of the water. There, check it out. Bizarre, man. A little bit scary as well. When you see it move, it's a little bit freaky.
Yeah. But the idea Boston, a la Boston robotics, eh?
Yeah, man. Not as dangerous as the dogs.
Yeah.
You know, that can move silently and open doors for each other. But if you woke up with one of these on your pillow, you'd freak out. But the idea being here that these will be used, obviously, to explore areas of the depths that are very difficult to reach or maybe harmful to other robots quite cumbersome in that space, and will ultimately then help with cleanup operations. Imagine an army of 1,000 of these little critters going, just find it, break down that plastic.
Doesn't it completely fascinate you still that there is so much of the deep blue that we haven't explored yet and like what lies beneath?
We're about to travel maybe 100, 200,000 kilometers away from our planet, yet 1 kilometer down, we still don't know
what's here. We haven't gotten that far yet. Imagine being able to get those visuals. Oh, man. Anyway, some of the stories that I've found our clickers online. Let us know what you've been exploring. Share the stories with us online. Hashtag Espresso Show when you do so.